We are the paradoxical ape. Bipedal, naked, large-brained, long the master of fire, tools, and language, but still trying to understand ourselves. Aware that death is inevitable, yet filled with optimism. We grow up slowly. We hand down knowledge. We empathize and deceive. We shape the future from our shared understanding of the past. CARTA brings together experts from diverse disciplines to exchange insights on who we are and how we got here. An exploration made possible by the generosity of humans like you.
Hello, my name is Rusty Gage from the Salk Institute. I'm a co-director for CARTA. It's my pleasure to welcome you here this afternoon. Among the oldest questions that we humans have asked ourselves are, who are we? What are we doing here? Where do we come from? How did we get here? And where are we going? Of these questions, where did we come from and how did we get here are of particular importance to anthropogeny. The key word in CARTA's name is anthropogeny, the scientific quest to explain the origins of humans. Anthropogeny is at the intersection of humanities and natural sciences, and we believe that the only way to address these two important questions is to draw evidence from these very different disciplines. This symposium is brought to you by the Center for Academic Research and Training in Anthropogeny, or CARTA. CARTA is a transdisciplinary collaboration between faculty at UC San Diego and the Salk Institute, along with interested scientists and other institutions whose mission is to explore and explain the origins of the human phenomenon. CARTA is co-directed by Ajit Varki, myself, and Margaret Schoeninger, with Pascal Guinot as the associate director. I'd like to take this opportunity to offer special thanks to CARTA's major sponsors, Annette Merrill Smith, Nissi and Ajit Varki, and an anonymous, generous donor. I'd also like to thank CARTA's benefactors and patrons listed here on the CARTA website. With lasting gratitude, CARTA is indebted to the G. Harold and Lytle Y. Mathers Charitable Foundation of New York. Closed captions for the recordings of this symposium is made possible by CARTA patrons, Ingrid Bernushka Perkins and Gordon Perkins, increasing the access and the reach of CARTA's free live stream symposium. Additional support for this symposium is provided by CARTA friends, Robert Stavros and Robert Mashman, and the CARTA supporters, Carrie Steinbach and Sasha Newman. As you enjoy today's presentations, we invite you to consider what contributions you might make to extend the understanding of the human journey. And we invite you to join CARTA sponsors today. Follow the link here shown to learn more about that. Thanks to the staff at CARTA and UCSD-TV for the work behind the scenes. And thank you, our viewers. Through your interest and the dedicated efforts of CARTA and our contributing partners, CARTA Symposia have become the number one science program aired at UCTV, amassing over 40 million views at the end of 2021. Explore the entire video library for free at the link shown here. On behalf of CARTA, I welcome you to this anthropogeny presentation on human origins and the humanities future, past, present, and the future of Anthropocene, co-chaired by Leslie Ayalo and Charles Kennell. Thank you, and I sincerely hope that you enjoy this symposium.
I'm Charlie Kennell, the Director Emeritus of the Scripps Institution of Oceanography. And we're all gathered here electronically to celebrate the memory of our friend and colleague, Paul Crutzen, who passed away last year. We've entitled our seminar, The Past, Present, and Future of the Anthropocene. Now, let me tell you a little something about Paul. He's done many, many things in science, but we're honoring him in particular for a word that he invented, Anthropocene. In the millennium year 2000, Crutzen and Eugene Sturmer gave us a word that captures the totality of humanity's impact on the planet. We humans are altering the land, the atmosphere, and the oceans so systematically that future scientists will characterize our time as a new geological era. The changes in biodiversity that we are seeing are an accelerated version of the other cataclysms in Earth history, where mass species extinctions accompanied the transition between geological eras. And we have a wonderful smorgasbord of topics for you on how our human origins and our future are connected. We'll hear from my friend and colleague Scripps Ram Ramanathan, who will give a personal appreciation of Paul Crutzen. We'll hear from Leslie Aiello, my co-convener from University College in London, who will speak on how humans evolved the capacity to change the entire planet. We'll hear where all our food has come from Michael Peruganan of New York University, whose talk is entitled The Domestication of Crops and the Anthropocene. We'll hear from a renowned expert on the world's other social species, ants. Mark Moffat will speak on the ants and the Anthropocene. I'll also give a few words on the coming crisis of the Anthropocene. We'll hear a timely discussion of the ecology and evolution of infectious diseases from Vanessa Izenwa of Yale University. Nancy Knowlton, my colleague, former Scripps colleague now at the Smithsonian in Washington, will speak on the oceans and the Anthropocene. My colleague David, known to his friends as Jonah Western, will speak on a topic close to my heart, we alone, how humans have conquered the planet and can also save it. And finally, my Cambridge colleague and the Astronomer Royal of England, Martin Reese, will give a cosmic view of potential utopian and dystopian futures.